In September this year, Muhammad Kavanda claimed to have lost one of his kidneys at Kampala Hospital after he had gotten an accident. However, according to the investigations carried out, Uganda Medical Dental Practitioners Council, it was revealed that Kavanda was born with one kidney and not two, as he claimed. This caused disbelief to Kavanda and many other people wondering how one can live with one kidney. However, according to Dr. P. Spagasha, it is normal for one to be born with one kidney.
Very possible for someone to be born with one kidney and not know it. I usually say that men usually don't know whether they have a kidney or not, but women usually find out, because women, when they are pregnant, they go for ultrasound scans. Men usually don't go for any kind of medical checks. So the only way to know if you have two kidneys is to do an ultrasound scan, and the sonographer will look at the kidneys and tell you that, okay, you have two kidneys. It's the only way to confirm. Because the kidneys, they work very well together, they support each other, and as they are supporting each other, if one is not working, you won't know, because the other one will take over the function of the other one.
She further explains what might cause a person to have one kidney.
And be a congenital abnormality. A congenital abnormality is like how someone can be born with one leg, or how someone can be born with one hand, okay? And then also sometimes diseases, it could be due to a disease that causes a congenital abnormality, okay? Usually, as the kidneys are forming, they ascend, we call it ascending, okay? So they're usually lower down in the pelvis, and then they grow until they reach where they're supposed to reach, up in the abdomen. So sometimes they may be blocked in their way, on their way as they are ascending, such that you find what we call an atopic kidney. It's out of where, it's out of the normal place where it should be.
According to Bagasha, if a person is not born with one kidney, they might get kidney failure, leading to loss of one kidney or even both. She further adds that kidney failure is a silent disease in Uganda.
If you have one kidney, you're just as normal as a person who has two kidneys. The only problem is that you don't have as much reserve, okay? So think of, say for example, a country, and you have an army, okay? So if you have an army, it will protect you, it will guard you, but you feel better when you have a reserve army on the sidelines. So if the frontline army doesn't, you know, things don't work out, then the reserve can come into place. That's exactly how it is when you have one kidney. So you have to protect it, just like how you protect your reserve, your frontline army, because you don't have any reserve. And how you protect it is the normal way anybody else should protect their kidneys. So you drink a lot of water, you check yourself, you should have an annual checkup, especially when you get to the age of 40 and above.
According to science, there is a possibility of one getting a new kidney through kidney transplant in case of a kidney failure, as Frank Asimu, a urologist and kidney specialist from Mulago Hospital, explains.
Preferably, we like to remove organs from age of 18 to 45. We don't want to harvest organs beyond 45 years, because beyond 45 years, you probably need your organs more than the other recipient. But there are some exceptions to all rules, so I'm talking about the mainstream. Similarly, we don't usually want to transplant patients who are more than 65 years. But that's a moving target. It can move to 70. It also depends on who it is and who is giving and the reasons. But beyond 65, beyond 70, at 75, you really must be considerate. Why are you removing an organ from a young person and putting it into this very old person? So the rule, which has got exceptions, we harvest from 18 to 45, and we transplant anywhere. Anyone can receive up the age of 65.
Specialists say kidney donation is good, as they advise anyone eligible to donate to do so. However, Dr. Frank Asimwe warns against selling kidney, which is illegal in Uganda.
The best would be if you had an identical twin. That is the person who would be the best donor for you. So when people come, and many people come, they say they've come to sell their kidneys. I tell them, thank you very much. Do you have a relative of yours who has kidney failure? Because that's the best person you can donate your kidney to.
Recently, the Parliament of Uganda passed the organ transplant bill, which awaits presidential approval. But Asimwe says any organ transplant has procedures and cannot be done by anyone.
Oh. there is not going to be any illegal harvest of organs in Uganda. It will not be there because the law will be stringent and will be prohibitive. But there's going to be organ donation for love of the recipient. My brother is sick, I have a kidney, I give him one, I stay with one. My father is sick, I give him one, I remain with one. My brother and so on and so forth, and my spouse and so on and so forth. So when we begin in Uganda, which is very soon, we begin with related donors. We begin with siblings, parents. Quickly we move to uncles and cousins. And it's likely to remain as such for a very long time.
He calls for sensitization of the public about this bill and cautions his fellow doctors about losing their credentials. Report compiled by John Mosenze for the news.